A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd December, on the front page you have Pan-India NRC never on the table, says Prime Minister. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has contradicted Home Minister Amit Shah's statement in Lok Sabha, and he said that NRC was never be considered for being implemented across the nation, and he also accused Congress and urban nixels of spreading lies. And here you can see in UP, two more deaths took place in violence during protests and cross firing by the police. And death toll here is 18 now. Then here you have food inflation spike transient, RBI governor. So RBI governor Shaktikant Das has said that recent spike in food inflation looks transient, but added that RBI needs to wait for a confirmation of this. So what steps need to be taken to intervene? If it's transient, it would pass by. So it's a waiting game which has to be played. Otherwise, active steps have to be taken to counter inflation. On page 7, you have more plastic pollution on Maharashtra beaches than Karnataka, Goa. So this is a study by Goa-based National Institute of Oceanography, which says that beaches in Maharashtra are more polluted with microplastics and macroplastics than those in Goa and Karnataka. So, such a phenomena of finding micro and macro plastic in abundance on Maharashtra beaches suggests that contaminants are land-based, like coming from near shore plastic industries, port areas, petroleum industries and high tourism activities. On page 9, you have Railway unveils new signaling system. So this project will be tested on 4 of the busiest routes. So this will start from April 2020 onwards. So it is expected to make train travel safer and faster. So you can see on 4 sections it would be implemented, and then it would be across India. So first is a pilot project. This is the signaling system. So Niti Aayog has to approve it, and the Extended Railway Board and the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. So after that it would be put into effect. So first it is trial. So what these modern technologies would be, as mentioned here, you can see automatic train protection system that helps in adhering to permissible speed limits without driver intervention, 4G based mobile train radio communication system which can be used for emergency communication. So these new systems will be implemented. And then below you have Arunachal to mark schools as hard and soft. So Arunachal Pradesh Education Department has been facing difficulties in posting teachers in remote areas. So it has decided to mark schools as hard, soft and medium based on geography, lack of infrastructure and reluctance of teachers to work beyond their comfort zone. So teacher absenteeism is a big problem here. So this is the situation of schools in Arunachal Pradesh. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is undoing harms. So making the Citizenship Amendment Act non-discriminatory is the only way to dispel fears. So this is what the editorial speaks of. If you remove religion-based discrimination, then there would be no problem in the Citizenship Amendment Act. Means any persecuted minority, any persecuted person can get citizenship in the country. Then here it is, significant reversal. So this is regarding NCLAT decision, National Company Law Appellate Tribunal decision to reverse the removal of Mr. Cyrus Mistry, which has come as a setback to Tata Sons. So he was a minority shareholder. So this is the major issue here in corporate governance. Then this is the three-step communal game plan. So this article talks of how NRC NPR process is used by Modi government to create a category of second class citizens. But presently on the front page we see Prime Minister has announced that there will be no NRC exercise across the nation. But then there should be no NRC exercise at all in pockets also. Then this is ironing out the wrinkles in trade dispute adjudication. So this is regarding World Trade Organization appellate body. So it has been seeing difficulties. So this is an opportunity to rectify issues with the present system is what this article talks about, because there were 3 members of World Trade Organization appellate body, and retirement of the 2 members which had remained now results in the appellate body without any members now. So the need for reforms here is what has been highlighted. On op-ed page, you have a Hindu critique of Hindutva. So this article says that we need to rescue religion from zealots and rediscover the spirit of religiosity. So here you can see this is a statement given here. Even though it may appear impossible to imagine a world where Kabir and Rumi, Gandhi and Maulana Azad, Tagore and Nizamuddin Aulia work with us, it is a task we ought to strive for. This is a photo showing Mahatma Gandhi and Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. Then this is mixed signals on NRC. So Prime Minister Modi's remarks on NRC contradict Home Minister's claim. So this brings out facts about the matter. On page 12, you have India, Iran agree to accelerate Chabahar port development. So Indians in Iran have raised concerns over Citizenship Act 2. But this was Foreign Minister, External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar, who met his Iranian counterpart in Tehran, and the two countries have agreed to accelerate the Chabahar port development, which has been under development for long now. And this is mixed response to Assam land plan. So this is regarding Assam government's effort to assuage tensions over Citizenship Amendment Act with a proposed legislation to protect the land rights of indigenous communities. But here also, the move to safeguard Assamese culture and land rights are seen as a ploy to end the anti-Citizenship Amendment Act protests. On page 13, you have an interview with RBI Governor Shaktikant Das, who says that counter-cyclical steps, structural reforms are needed to tackle the slowdown. So we saw on the front page too about food inflation situation. It looks transient is what the RBI Governor says, but it will still see, confirm, and then decide on steps. Then on international page, you have your news regarding Afghanistan elections. So incumbent president Ashraf Ghani is set for a second term in Afghanistan. President, he won by 50.64% of the votes against his rival Abdullah. These are the preliminary results out. And this is Kim discusses bolstering military as deadline looms. So North Korea has sought US concessions by end of December 2019 and the deadline looms. So if US does not provide concessions to it, then again it is trying to be aggressive and is bolstering its military. It may go for some tests, nuclear tests as such too. So this is the... And now here you have Hong Kong protesters rally for Uyghurs. So now Hong Kong protesters are raising their voice for Uyghur Muslims, at least 1 million Muslims who have been detained in Chinese camps, which China calls a re-education camps, but UN has also confirmed that these are detention centers. Below you have FATF puts 150 questions to Pakistan. So Financial Action Task Force, the global watchdog for terror financing and money laundering, has sought more clarification and data from Pakistan on actions taken by it against madrasas belonging to the banned outfits and other such questions. So Pakistan is already in the grey list and may enter into the blacklist if it does not comply with the norms and requirements of FATF. Then on Monday's business news is not there. It's money-wise coverage. It's not important. And last page has sports-related news. So that is it. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asr.com. Thank you.